Hackers have a brand new strategy to trick you that you'll want to know about and also warn your friends about, but fortunately, it's one of those where simply knowing about it is enough to protect yourself from it. However, there's a few different variations and it won't always look exactly the same, so that's what I'll go over. I'm Theo Joe, and let's get into it. So what is this new attack and how does it work? Well, it's being called ClickFix, and the name will make sense in a minute. As for how the scam starts out, there's going to be a huge variety in what exactly it looks like, but generally, you would come across a website that is going to claim that there is some kind of problem that you need to fix, or that there's some kind of verification that you have to do to continue. And it might seem that this is just going to be a usual scam of telling you to download some file, and then it ends up being a virus, but that's not it. Before I show you like what they actually have you do, here's some other examples of what it might actually look like. A pretty common one is it'll be a fake CAPTCHA looking thing. Another example might even be the Cloudflare type CAPTCHA style, but it might look very different. Like for example, even a fake MS Word document showing an error and this how to fix button, or even something like this fake Discord server invite page. And how you would stumble upon this malicious site could be from an email, or it could be malicious advertising, or even a compromised website. Anyway, regardless of what it looks like, the common goal between all of these malicious sites is not to get you to just download a file and run it, but rather to actually get you to run a command yourself on your computer. So in these examples, you'll probably notice that usually there's going to be some kind of button that you can click and it would copy the command to the clipboard, but you don't realize that's what it did. It'll just kind of say, press this button, and then for example, press the Windows key plus R, which will bring up the run box, and then it will say, press Control V, which will paste into it. And to hide the fact of what they just had you do, and for people who are less knowledgeable what they just did, they might even add padding of like some message before the command, so you don't realize that you just pasted a command into that box. And of course, it might not always look like this. It could be that they literally have on the page the full command viewable and just tell you that it does something else, and then you trust it and then run it. Now, once you run the command, you're infected, because what the command actually does is uses built-in tools into Windows, which are able to download and run a script from the internet in one go. So they have that malicious script hosted on some other web page, and then your command basically tells Windows, download and run it. Now, as for that script that the command downloaded, really, it could be doing anything, but typically, that's going to be a slightly more advanced script as opposed to just the short command that says download and run this. But that script usually is going to download a final payload, like the actual virus files. And obviously, this could be any kind of virus, but often recently it's been stealer type malware where it will steal all your credentials, all your logins and stuff, which because they have the cookies, they're already logged in. They basically bypass all your passwords and two-factor authentication. And also they're gonna look for any crypto wallets and really any other data on your computer. They're just gonna exfiltrate it and upload it to the hacker. So basically, the hacker will have access to whatever information they want on your computer. And also a lot of times this malware will have persistence techniques. So even if you delete it, they may add a task scheduler task so that when Windows launches, even if you deleted the malware or something, it will re-download it and reinstall it every single time. And if you don't know to look for that, then you'll just be reinfected every time. And as for the name it's being called, ClickFix, it's because basically the web pages usually say to click something to fix whatever problem they presented. It might not always use just the run box though, there's a couple other possibilities. Before I continue on to that though, another great way to protect yourself is with today's sponsor, Bitdefender, and their all-in-one security plan, Bitdefender Premium Security. It's more than just some antivirus program, but a complete security suite, including advanced threat defense, which can protect against brand new malware by analyzing its behavior, not just relying on signatures, though of course it can detect them that way too. And relevant to this video, it can even scan command line commands like the type that I've been talking about. Bitdefender can detect even more though. It also detects malicious scripts, process memory, and keyloggers, for example. And with features like network threat prevention, it can stop network attacks before they begin by blocking malicious attempts on system vulnerabilities and brute force attacks. With Bitdefender Premium Security, you even get protection for your mobile devices, where it can detect malicious links even when they appear in SMS messages, chat apps, calendar invites, or mobile app URLs. It also has online scam protection through their Scam Copilot AI platform, which includes features like scam ad detection to block block or fake malicious ads, blocking scam websites, and detecting new scam patterns. And right now, you can get a special 90-day extended free trial to Bitdefender Premium Security through the link in the description. So be sure to check out the link down there. And with all that being said, let's continue. All right, now, like I said, it might not always be the run box that they use. So don't think just because it's not the run box that they can't trick you this way. For example, in the past, hackers would have users paste into the command prompt. Another thing you need to be aware of is it's actually sometimes possible for the browser to run a command itself with the user confirmation. And what that could look like, for example, is if you see this little pop-up at the top of the browser where it asks to open another app. You see, Windows has multiple different built-in URL protocols, they're called. So you might already know about HTTPS, that's before web addresses. But there's other ones that are special for apps that can be registered in Windows. Like for example, MS Calculator. If you type that in with a colon at the end, it will literally open the calculator app. And then there's some other protocols that can actually take commands at the end of it. For example, the one for the clock, you could do MS clock pause focus timer, and it will actually pause the timer if there's one running. And apparently, hackers also figured out that there's one way they can use commands for Windows Explorer to somehow run commands. So there was this example where it literally said the browser would like to open Explorer. And without getting into the specific technicals of how, it apparently creates a shortcut file that looks like a PDF and then opens Explorer to it. And then if you open the shortcut is actually what runs the malicious command. So it's not like one that has you pasted in. So just know that that's what this little box means. If you see it, it means that either a link that you clicked on or even just typed into the browser URL bar is a command that will try to open an app. So be aware of that, and it could run a command. Now, obviously for that one, it's possible that there's legitimate purposes. A lot of times apps may open a web browser and then use it for authentication, and then it'll open the same app back up. So just because you see that doesn't mean it's malicious, but if you go to a website and unexpectedly see it, then it's at least a word of caution. Also, I should point out that this ClickFix attack is not just for Windows. Hackers have also created versions of the pages for macOS and specific scripts for that. And for example, there's one where if you run the command, then it will ask you to prompt for the password. And then if you type it in, thinking it's a legit thing, then it will actually save your password that you just typed in, download the payload, and then it will now have access to that password that it also saved. And every time it wants to do anything malicious, it'll have the access to bypass any security because of your password. So don't think it's just Windows. Now, as for the malicious commands that get run, these could look very different, and they might even be obfuscated to completely hide what is going on with it and make it impossible to see what it's actually doing. Sometimes you might be able to actually tell that there's a URL in there, but you can't even necessarily trust that because, for example, they might hide the fact that they're downloading a script by adding like a fake file extension such as MP3 or MP4, making it look like, oh, well, it's accessing some kind of video or audio file. But you have to realize that the tool that it's using to download and run the script doesn't even care about the file extension. It could be a script with an MP3 extension. It's still going to run and be malicious. So in terms of protecting yourself, the good news is that this type of attack inherently requires user interaction. So if you know about what to spot, you should be good. And basically that means never type in a command into the run box that the website just says to do to fix. That's nonsense. Or if it tells you to paste a command anywhere, like the command prompt, or also be aware of that thing that is going to maybe try to open apps like Explorer. And I mean, just be extremely suspicious in general if a website tells you that to fix some kind of problem, you have to do something outside the browser, you're probably better off just not trusting it. I think the reason this is probably going to be more popular is because a lot of times up until now, usually a virus spreads by pretending to be some kind of file or program that the user is already looking for. But to spread that way, it would really only work for a user who is trying to find a file specifically to download. If a user is just browsing the web and all of a sudden some website says, download this thing and run it, obviously you're not going to do that. Hopefully. But this ClickFix thing can trick anyone, not just people looking to download something because they think, oh, it's one of these verification things. And I mean, we all know that those verification tests are getting more and more complicated. So I mean, it's kind of understandable that it's like, well, now you got to do this extra thing. And it's just maybe an annoyance, you might think, but really it's extremely malicious. And then you don't even realize that it is actually downloading something just in a different way than you might expect. So just be on the lookout, and you can also warn your friends, maybe share this video with them. Thanks again to Bitdefender for sponsoring, and be sure to check out the 90-day extended free trial of Bitdefender Premium Security through the link in the description. Now, I did mention this scam a while ago as part of my video about new scams in 2025, so I'll put that link right there you can click on. I go over a lot more stuff, so I highly recommend it. So definitely check that out, and if you want to subscribe, I try to make videos about twice a week, so it should be worth it. Of course, if you like the video, give it a thumbs up. It all helps. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.